see now.
Hello, my name is Matthew Marvin, aka the Poker Gypsy.
Today, I will be reviewing a hand that I played in the 2-2 cash game live stream in Jacksonville, Florida at Best Bet.
The hand I'm going to review today is a bluff gone wrong. If you watch all my hands throughout this video, you will actually see a few of these same situations. But I wanted to review this one because even though it didn't work out in my favor, I played the hand correctly. Yes, it's an actual thing in poker. Now, when I play cash games, I usually buy in for the minimum and play short stack poker. To me, buying in for the minimum and running it up to ungodly numbers is always the goal. It's just way more glorifying than sitting with 1,000 and doubling it. For all of you hotheads out there, understand that the top pros consider a 2-2 table and average $300 per night. Anyone telling you that they do better than this is either top 2% player or is buying in with a huge stack and taking pictures of it, posting it to social media, acting like they won it all. The very first buy-in charge is at 14 minutes and 35 seconds. We're going to start this hand off at an hour and 23 minutes. I'm in the four seat in a small blind. A good player out of Texas who goes by E. He's straddling for $4, which makes me first to act. I've got King 8 suited. I call. Everyone else decides to fold. E checks his option. We're heads up. Flop comes 2-9-10. Aggressive E bets $5. It's most likely that he's either bluffing or betting into something. So I raise him to $10. I raise here to $10 for a few reasons. One, my opponent's known to be aggressive. Two, most players don't bet anything but an overpair here. Three, raising here sends my opponent the message that I have a strong hand. If he doesn't have a big hand, he slows down on the turn. My opponent's aggressive, but he isn't a maniac. E flat calls at $10. At this point, if my opponent has a big hand, I would most likely see a re-raise. The turn comes a 9. There's now 2 cards to a flush draw on the board, but I'm out of position with an aggressive player behind me. So I check. E checks behind, and that's when I know his hand is weak at this point. A queen comes on the river. Now it's possible that my opponent has 8-jack or jack-king, and he's just made a straight. And pretty much any 2 cards are in his range. The fact is, I've got 2 options at this time. I can check and let my opponent bet me out of the pot, or I can take a stab at it. It's a small pot, it won't cost me much. I bet $15 into a $30 pot. E hit his queen on the river. He calls and wins the pot. I don't regret the way I played this hand. If we could run it back 100 times, I'd play it the same exact way.
My YouTube channel, The Poker Boy, you should know me by now. Brad Owen.